Even though most people's toilets are a stone's throw away from their showers, 42% of people admit to urinating while standing under one. But for 30-year-old Crystal, nothing makes it down the plug hole. Although she hoovers and polishes it every day, her shower is for exhibition only.
This shower, we don't use it. It's for display purposes.
Crystal spends 5 hours a day keeping her two-bedroom London apartment spotless.
When I'm cleaning, I have to time the cleans. It's like a military operation. I need to get it done.
And nothing's clean unless it smells good enough to eat.
Smell is very important. It's the most important thing.
The smell of apple is delicious. I just love it.
Although she's not OCD diagnosed, Crystal starts her daily cleaning routine at 5 a.m.
There's always something to do. We've got mirror splashbacks. I'm polishing that, I'd say, in the 50s, 50 times a day.
And top of her cleaning list are her bed sheets, which are washed and ironed every day.
Once it comes out of the dryer, it's still a little bit crinkly. So I think everyone should iron their sheets.
So pay attention.
Aussie Crystal has an 8-month-old son with her partner of 2 years.
Ooh, messy boy.
But worries that her obsessive cleaning will ruin her plans for a big wedding.
I feel like if anyone is neglected, it may be my partner. I'd like to get married, but if I'm constantly choosing cleaning over spending time with somebody, why would they want to marry me?
Crystal will be heading north to meet someone with very different priorities when it comes to cleanliness.
I'm pretty direct. I will speak my mind. If I feel like something is not right, then I'll just let them know.
Leaving her crystal clean apartment, she's travelled 140 miles to Birmingham.
Wow, lots of overgrown grass. Please go around to the back door as bell not working. Oh, scary.
It's nigh on impossible to navigate around this place without tripping or slipping. Tripped over down here and went face planted myself into the carpet.
That was quite good.
52-year-old former nurse April lives with her husband and son in their 3-bedroom house on the outskirts of Birmingham. The home has not been deep cleaned in 7 years.
I don't spend a lot of time in this house. There's too much stuff in it, it's too close. It becomes like a prison.
Stuck. My husband moved into my house 5 years ago and bought his house down here. Then he moved out, didn't take anything with him, furnished a flat, moved back in again. It just accumulates stuff, I don't know, it's like it appears out of thin air.
Okay.
With the clutter piling up, April still won't allow her husband, Paul, to lift a finger.
April thinks that because I've been to work all day, I shouldn't have to come home and clean.
But since April had a hip operation 3 years ago, she's found it difficult to keep on top of the housework.
Even though I know I'm physically not able to do it, I still think it should be my job to do it because I'm not working, so I feel it should be me that's doing it.
April cares for and relies on her 23-year-old son, Alan. He has learning difficulties and is an avid collector of Lego and games.
Al.
Yeah?
Come on.
Oh, I'll move it in a bit.
Whatever. Alan doesn't particularly like cleaning because it's time that he feels is wasted when he could be playing his games. True? False?
That is correct.
With a house to run and a son to look out for, music lover April struggles to find time for herself.
I would just love this room to be somewhere where I could just come and chill and play my organ, play the clarinet, which I haven't done for years.
With no room to move, April realises she needs help.
The house now is out of control. I need help. I know I need help. And it's got to the stage where I don't know where to start.
Ken, there's a fag in the bed.
You? How did that get there?
There's a fag in the bed.
They dragged me to the floor and one of them was straddled across me and said, get me something to kill.